Welcome to the You Person Podcast, a deep dive into how a new way of knowing is developing holistic, innovative leaders at all levels of the organization and changing the way business does business. I'm your host, James Tuznia, and a big shout out to Lindsay Sterling for our highly evocative theme music, Between Twilight.
So just to talk about the power of platform and then why a leader 6.0 is necessary, just to give you some of the statistics about it. In 2007, five major mobile phone manufacturers, Nokia, Samsung, Motorola, Sony Ericsson, and LG, they collectively controlled 90% of the industry's profit, global profits. By 2015, the iPhone single-handedly generated 92% of global profits, while all but one of the former incumbents made no profit at all. So how can we explain iPhone's rapid domination of its industry? And how can we explain the competitors' freefall? And what they're saying in this article, it was about the platform and how Apple conceived of the iPhone and its operating system as more than a product or a conduit for service. It was a way to connect participants in two-sided markets, app developers on one side and app users on the other, generating value for both groups. And then as it grew, it created this phenomenon of network effects, which is central to platform strategy. Now, of course, business has turned it into strategy and made this a case study. We're actually pointing to what it is to cultivate your life, your unique signature, use that as you go to work on projects and all those other things we said
Can I say that, you know, when you're talking about the two-way market, that the platforming employed, and then you bring that to the unique signature and the question of fragmented teams, that when it was just a product and there was more of a one-way view about how to do business,
yep,
that was a kind of fragmenting of the market. That then if you bring that same two-way or ecosystem view to how one brings their unique signature, if as an app developer, I have my app and there's the voice that I bring to my app, and I'm now Apple gave me a platform to bring it, to have this two-way thing going, if that's the view on a team, I'm bringing my unique signature in a two-way conversation that I'm saying, you're going to meet my unique signature as I bring mine, and together we're going to contribute value in all directions. So that's a kind of innate remedy for team fragmentation that both includes value creation that is integral to someone's fully embodying their unique signature.
That's
a remedy, if you will, for team fragmentation.
Totally. When I entered into Bill initially with such severe breakdown, others went to work on the financial side of things. I went to work on the kind of fragmentation that had happened with people in the company. What started to pull them together? I can't say that I had, I'm going to build this platform and we're going to put these things in place. What I had in front of me was, we're going to give people life mission. And in that life mission, I could see what you just said. I could see that future that wanted to emerge. And I started to talk about it. And that's what attracted people to Bell. And that's also what had people hang in there with the serial crisis that occurred, because they were hungry for their unique signature, their unique life signature. They were hungry for that. And they were hungry for a different way to work. And when I could, I mean, I could talk about it a whole lot better now in terms of what we've done so far and what you're pointing to and what you just said, Daniel. And that's partly what I'm beginning to pull together to build what's next for Bill. The prototype of it, I guess my point is, the prototype of it when I came in and in beginning to talk about it in the ways that I did that had people go, wait, what? And so then the work that we did with the level one life mission, level two life mission, level three life mission actually had people understand oh, we could put this together as people in their life mission. That's how it was talked about then. And the initial prototyping of the constellation had this up front. So Paul, he didn't get it in the beginning, but the more he stayed in the Life Mission 1 and Life Mission 2 work that we did, and then in the Life Mission 3, he said, wow, this really could be something much different for business. And so when he put together the constellation that included Kevin and Matt, who were also, Kevin left for a while, but Matt was in all those programs, they started to put that in place in the constellation prototyping that they were doing. And it actually had people come together in a much different way with such fulfillment and satisfaction.
Well, what Life Mission did was interrupt burnout, interrupt the hard and the suffering in which they were finding themselves, because there was no movement necessarily, and they were just working harder, faster, more. And so Life Mission started to evolve or break up the old relationship they had with their signature and open up a doorway to a new relationship they could have with their personal signature.
To bring people into the company that had not done any of that education, just to show how quickly you can build up a platform and take down a platform. Where we are now is people really saying, what happened to Life Mission? Like, what happened to that? Because that really is why I'm here. So some of the young managers who were engaged in Life Mission 3 and in the project we did where we had crew and assistants and managers all in Life Mission 3 and in the Life Mission 1 and 2 work, they all got a sense of what that could be like. And then bringing in the traditional 4.0 thinking just sucked it back into a vacuum. And we're now starting to pull that out and bring some things back in. There's such two different conversations, and the stewardship and the attention and the effort that it's going to take, which isn't struggle. It doesn't have to be that, but that kind of attention is really part of how a platform needs to get built. And so I would say we went deeper into where the effort needs to be in how we're beginning to put this together. I mean, it just was the pathway that happened given how everything went down.
Thank you for listening to this episode of the You Person Podcast. If you are new to the podcast, please head over to our website, theyoupersonproject.com, where you can subscribe to the podcast, learn more about the project, or connect with our team. You can also reach us at hello@theyoupersonproject.com. If you think of someone who will benefit from listening to this podcast, please do share it with them. Thank you again, and see you on the next episode of the You Person Podcast.